Hello everyone, I am Nadia Patel. Welcome back to our Unified Modeling Language lecture series. Let us get started with our next point of next unit, which is Unified Modeling Language Diagrams Part 2 and Introduction to Software Testing. We are in continuation to interaction diagrams, which is a part of behavioral diagrams, and now in this lecture we are going to study the first interaction diagram, which is the sequence diagram. So points which we are going to cover are sequence diagram introduction, symbols used in sequence diagram, meaning of symbols or notations. So let us get started with our lecture and understand what exactly these sequence diagrams are. So as this is a part of interaction diagram, the first thing which we should keep in our mind is that we have to capture or focus on interactions. These interactions are going to take place between objects of either same module or objects of two different modules, or these interaction could be internal or external as well. So as the name is suggesting, this diagram is definitely going to give us a sequence of interaction. So it is primarily going to focus on the sequence of interaction, the sequence of message passing. So interaction between objects in the form of a two-dimensional chart is exactly a sequence diagram. This chart should be read from top to bottom. It is used for analysis and documentation process by developers. It helps to find current business logic for any software. It helps to find current and future requirements needed for the system. It shows sequence of messages passed between two objects. Objects are represented using rectangles with object name underlined inside it. Messages are placed in chronological order of their occurrence. This is an important statement. We are going to show the sequence of messages passed between two objects. These messages should be placed in chronological order. That means there has to be a perfect or a correct sequence of their occurrence. Each message is labeled with the message name and some control information. Now let us go through what different elements or symbols of sequence diagrams are going to be. So one more thing which you should note, that these diagrams are the simplest diagrams, but we are going to draw these diagrams in detail. So it is making use of a very less amount of symbols, but we are going to make use of this 4-5 symbols and draw a detailed diagram showing the message flow and interaction between the objects. So as the interaction diagrams overview or introduction has got started, we are speaking about one element which is the most important element, that is the object. So objects involved in the sequence of events are going to be used. We are going to place these objects at the top of our diagram. They are going to be placed across horizontal axis. So we need to make use of this rectangle symbol. Do not forget and note that object name should start with a colon and should always be underlined. Now one more rule is that when you work with sequence diagram, I have read it in some reference books, that only those objects which according to you and your system are the important ones are only underlined. But some reference book also stated that every object or even classes should start with a colon and underline. So for simplicity, either you can underline those objects which according to your system are the most important one, or you can underline all of them and colon is must. You should start the name of the object with a colon. The second symbol is the lifeline. So it is represented with a dashed, or you can say a dotted line, but mostly dashed line. So there is a difference between a dashed line and a dotted line. Dashed line has some small dashes involved and dotted has some dots. So make use of the dashed line symbol for lifelines. As the name is suggesting, the lifeline is the lifespan of an object. It should be drawn from the base of object. So in the objects part, we saw that it is across the horizontal axis. That means it is the first object or first element which you should draw. After that, you are supposed to draw the lifelines. So draw from the base of the object. That means from here, you should start drawing your lifeline from here. The lifeline should extend down the vertical axis. It indicates the lifespan, the span of an object over a period of time. The next symbol is the message passing symbol. Again, an important symbol. So the sending messages and the reply messages. This is the most important element of a sequence diagram. They show when one object calls another for an operation. They are labeled, very important. They should be labeled. It indicates the span, lifespan of an object over a period of time. Now, mostly this point is a contrasting kind of a point. This point should be majorly kept into the lifeline section. And the first three points should be used for the messages. So while drawing the messages, one thing which you should remember is the sending messages should be drawn from left hand side to the right hand side. And the response messages, that means if you're sending a message, there should be a response or there should be a reply message, that should be drawn from the right hand side to the left hand side. So the arrowhead should be placed accordingly. The next symbol is the activation symbol. They show the active state of an object. They show the period of time one object performs an action. They are kept on top of object's lifeline. So the sequence now is the object first, then the lifeline, and then these activation boxes. They also denote that the processes are proceeded or they are performed in response to messages. So this is all about the four major important notations of our sequence diagram. I hope you understood. So the basic use, you can say, or the focus of our sequence diagram should be on capturing the interaction and giving us the sequence of messages. So the name is suggesting it is a sequence diagram. Do not forget to draw and write messages in the right sequence. That's it. Thank you. Thanks for watching. I hope you understood. It was the most simplest diagram by far. Thank you very much.